In this video, I want to talk about how to set up IP filters inside your Google Analytics account. Setting up IP filters is important because if you are visiting your own website, and you will probably be visiting it a lot of times throughout the day, you don't want your visits to count as visitors inside Analytics. So what I will do is that I will go ahead and search for my IP address. So I just need to search for what is my IP. And this will give my IP address. So sometimes this IP address will be static. In this case, my IP address is a static IP address right now where I am doing the recording from. Sometimes it will be a range. So the first two sets of the IP address will be the same, and the next two sets will be constantly changing every time you connect to the internet. So if it is a dynamic IP address, I will show you how to add it to Analytics. So in this case, it's a static IP address. So I will go to admin, and inside admin, I will click on all filters. So once I go into all filters, I will click on add filter, and filter name would be own IP address. So here I would exclude traffic from the IP address, and I would give this IP address here. So I need to apply this filter to all website data, and I need to click on save. So here I need to say that are equal to. So if it is a dynamic IP address, what you can do is that you can just remove the last two parts of the IP address, and you can say that any IP address that begins with this particular range should be eliminated. Be careful that sometimes even the beginning two ranges might be allocated to other people. So you might want to be a little bit careful with it. So here, since this is a static IP address, I'm just adding this IP address, and let me go ahead and click on save. So that's it. We have added the filter to our Analytics account, and this is something that you have to set up early on, as soon as you set up your Analytics account, because this does not apply to the historical data. This applies only to the new data that starts coming in after the filter has been set up. Apart from the IP filter, I would also like to set up one more quick filter called the lowercase filter. So what happens is that when people go ahead and create campaign URLs, sometimes they include capitalization in their URLs. So Google Analytics takes the URL and it is case sensitive. So if certain URLs are having caps and if certain URLs are not having caps, they are treated as different pages by Google Analytics. So what this filter does is that it will change all the campaign names into lowercase. So I would name the filter as lowercase campaign name. I would click on custom, and here I would select lowercase, and in this I would select campaign name. So if you scroll down and if you click on this, you will also be able to understand what it exactly means. So URLs like thankyou.html with the capital T will be converted into thankyou.html with a small t. So this is something that Google Analytics will help you do automatically. So I would click on all website data, and I will click on save. So this filter has been added. You will also be able to verify the filters. So to verify the filters, you can click on back, and here inside view, go ahead and click on filters. Click on the filter name, let's say lowercase campaign name, and here there will be an option to verify the filter. So you can click on verify the filter. So right now it is not able to verify the filter because it says that the set of sample data is too small. Not enough URLs have been triggered with capital URLs to apply this filter. So there are other filter verification systems. One is using Google Tag Assistant, which we will discuss in the upcoming videos. So thank you for watching this video, and I will see you in the next video.